நானும் என் குடும்பமும் ரொம்ப எந்த வருமானமும் இல்லாத ரொம்ப கஷ்டமா இருக்கு. எல்லா பெண்களும் 100 நாள் வேலைக்கு தான் போறாங்க. அந்த 100 நாள் வேலையும் எங்களுக்கு மாசத்துல ஒரு வாரம் தான் கொடுக்குறாங்க. மருத்துவ வசதியும் கிடையாது. எங்களுக்கு மருத்துவ சிகிச்சை செய்யறதுக்கு எந்த வாய்ப்பும் கிடையாது.
India, the world's largest democracy and one of the fastest growing mega economies of the planet. India's economy has grown exponentially since the end of 20th century. Almost 2/3 of India's population lives in rural areas as of 2019. Most of these people engage in agriculture or agro-related business activities to make a living. While rural India comprises such a large part of India's population, it has been largely left behind on the developmental track.
The Indian MSME sector is the backbone of the Indian economy. Enactus SRM believes in promoting the concept of micro-enterprises in rural India to encourage self-sustenance and growth. When we say micro-enterprises, we emphasize on serving needs that are specific only to that particular population, that is, rural communities serving hyper-local markets. It was this ideology that drove us to establish our first project.
Prakrit is a grassroots entrepreneur initiative by Enactus SRM to create women entrepreneurs with the motto saving the environment. Project Prakrit mainly focuses on the manufacturing of reusable paper bags, which are used as the alternative to plastic bags. The production units were first set up at the village Anjur, where 6 women from the community started the production. Within the span of 2 months, the manufacturing units were diversified to 3 more communities from other villages in the Kanchipuram district, with a total of 20 women working under the umbrella of Project Prakrit, catering to more than 30 small business owners and shopkeepers.
The women at Anjur had been facing a variety of problems before starting work. These problems were of a social nature rather than an economic one and required parallel efforts in the village along with the paper bag enterprise itself. They were suffering from patriarchal pressure and stereotypical mindsets at home. As a result of this, the responsibility of bread earning solely fell on their male counterparts. An increased reliance of the community on government schemes, subsidies and CSR funds from Mahindra World City and the lack of awareness, education and employability skills were constantly visible on them, which also prevented them from being truly Atmanirbhar or self-reliant.
Chengalpattu area has been over past couple of years combating a troubling issue of single-use plastic bags. Due to the increased number of stray animals on the street, single-use plastic bags pose a great threat to flora and fauna in the suburban Tamil Nadu region. SRM University, a major contributor to the area's carbon footprint in its efforts to reduce the use of plastic in campus, has been vigorously pushing for greener options. Enactus SRM capitalized on this prevailing problem and we implemented our guiding insights to establish a paper bag manufacturing unit with the newly recruited women of Anjur as its workforce.
Incentives have been historically proven as a way to motivate the workforce to go the extra mile. Keeping this in mind, we believe economic development must precede social reform. Consistently upskilling people has become a necessity to transform humans into human resources. Multiple training workshops to teach paper bag holdings, keeping inventory, concept of assembly lines are now. And now, during the pandemic, a workshop on making masks has been conducted at Anjur.
We employed a new working model for Project Prakrit, which begins with Enactus members themselves learning techniques that require success in their enterprise and teaching a few keen entrepreneurs in the target community. Upon application of those techniques, the entrepreneurs improve their methods and processes and go on to train new business experience.
Project Prakrit implemented novel marketing, distribution and entrepreneurial techniques in order to have a greater impact. Pursuing a B2B business model rather than a B2C model that targeted small business owners who could earn a profit selling these bags rather than handing out plastic bags for free. Hyperlocal distribution gave us an edge over our competitors as it minimized our logistical costs. This allowed us to have a more intensive feedback loop to customize our paper bags and have a better rapport with our customers. SRM campus, being a hotspot for fests and campus activities, was always in demand for paper bags. Our sales chart is a testament to the fact.
And Enactus project's success is a direct measure of the amount of impact created, both direct and indirect. A major step forward for us was to see Prabhavati and her friends teach the skills we had imparted to the other women of the community, and these same women gleaming with joy when their bank accounts were deposited with their first pay. Along with the economical and social impacts, Project Prakrit managed to reduce the sale of plastic bags in Chengalpattu area.
With greater financial independence and the skills to get employed, these women and their families came to rely less on welfare schemes tasks like MNREGA, which are already stressed. Indirectly, we reduce pressure on such schemes regionally, allowing them to function better while simultaneously creating positive ecological impact.
Multiple classroom projects and workshops were held by our very own NACTES SRM members on topics of general awareness, computer skills and self-presentation. Under the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, we have been organizing health camps and sanitation workshops in collaboration with SRM Hospital and the Public Health Department every month. Our doctors provide them with basic medical checkups, counseling and resources to stay healthy.
Much of the credit for India's success story goes far beyond the concrete jungles of modern cities and far deeper than its glaring urban localities. Project Prakrit is a story about the spirit of India, the core of this gigantic machine that runs with 1.3 billion people at its heart. This story is about India's micro-business and India's villages.
Sri Rudra Milk, a milk collection center in the heart of village Risama, Chhattisgarh, started its collection business 3 years back. The concept was simple: collect milk from the individual suppliers in Risama and provide the same to a cooperative society which feeds the inner cities in the Chhattisgarh.
However, Ms. Lata Chandrakar, owner of the enterprise, began to notice stagnated growth after the first 2 years of business. At this point, NITS SRM contacted Ms. Chandrakar and offered to provide marketing consultancy services to help Sri Rudra Milk Center regain its growth rate.
विगत 3 वर्ष पूर्व हमने यह संस्थान चालू किया था। प्रथम वर्ष में काफी समस्याएं आई, जैसे दूध का मिलावट हो जाना, किसानों का कम आना, कैन के द्वारा परिवहन, दूध में फैट का कम आना, इसके वजह से हमारे बिजनेस में काफी नुकसान भी हुआ। फिर हमें से जानकारी मिली, एसआरएम एनएक्टेस के सदस्यों से फिर हमने मदद मांगी और उनसे सलाह लेने के बाद हमारा बिजनेस अच्छा हुआ और उन्होंने हमारी समय समय पर सलाह दी।
After careful market analysis, Team Kasba deduced that Sri Rudra Milk's client base mostly consisted of big suppliers who would provide around 30 to 40 liters per day and were already in good relationship with the Chandrakar family. To encourage growth, smaller suppliers who supply in the increments of 2 to 10 liters per day had to be acquired. An immediate solution was to create a sales force and a sales strategy. Students from the neighboring Shail Devi Mahavidyalaya College were recruited as interns and provided with effective soft skill training in sales and marketing domains. Then they were assigned territories and were given leads. This being a village without effective business communication channels, a door-to-door marketing strategy was employed. However, turnout from the same was very low, so a different strategy was adopted.
Now the Team Kasba's first job was to create a database of existing cow owners in Risama, since no such repository existed. To circumvent this issue, Team Kasba got in touch with the local veterinarian and obtained all the contacts of all cow owners who came in for the checkups in the vicinity. A quasi-village meeting of the cow owners with Ms. Chandrakar was organized to try and pitch the idea there. The strategy worked out well, as we realized sales and marketing in rural areas, unlike the urban settings, were largely based on the concept of trust, influence and a face time with the owner.
Soon, Sri Rudra Milk Center noticed a 10% growth in the first quarter of 2020. Not only were big farmers supplying milk, but a substantial number of small suppliers would line up every day to provide 2 to 5 liters each. Kasba has benefited the farmers as now they have a source of an alternative income, which makes them more self-sustained.
Without external investment, a spur in the rural economy was created by proper management of existing resources to generate cash flow. Predicting further growth in the second and third quarters of 2020, Team Kasba had to implement preemptive strategies that would allow it to tackle increasing operational costs and sustain Sri Rudra Milk's revenue.
The team reckoned that the centrifuge was the bottleneck in the entire milk collection process. This would often increase the time to process transactions, in turn increasing the labor charge and the other operational expenditures. Anticipating the increased supply in the coming months, Team Kasba advised Sri Rudra Milk to buy a second centrifuge that would allow them to operate more effectively. With this attempt being successful, we aim to assist Sri Rudra Milk to open a collection centers and expand in Chhattisgarh.
Enactus SRM, along with Team Spas, a leading UAV R&D organization in Chennai, have launched Project Flylife. Launched with the support of the Ford Fund, Flylife is India's first drone logistics and transport service for the Indian healthcare sector. With the onset of the pandemic, and social distancing being in practice, there has been a surge in e-commerce sales online. These companies are also faced with multiple challenges such as supply chain disruptions, delivery issues, low manpower, and most importantly, exposure of working human resources to the virus. Being a frontline fighter of the pandemic and providing essentials, these outfits need to be effectively equipped and efficiently running to deal with the situation properly. FlyLife aims to be an emergency light cargo delivery service primarily for the healthcare organizations dealing with COVID-19. Providing PPE kits, masks, IR temperature scanners, blood, medicines, etc. on an emergency ad hoc basis to hospitals in the greater Chennai area. We will also strive to offer essential delivery services via drones in containment zones and to people who are home restricted. FlyLife plans to assist on-ground NGOs and NPOs serving rural areas during lockdowns with its logistical services. TeamSpas, a leading UAV research organization, has developed a roadmap and is on the way to create a drone that allows for efficient use of energy with purpose-oriented designs, features such as tilt-rotor maneuvering, a hybrid quad-plane design, and GSM telemetry, which will allow us to effectively function as a delivery service. In order to be able to launch operations by April 2021, FlyLife aims to have its prototype ready for testing by February 2021. In the meantime, our business innovation team is constantly looking for further investments to make this project possible. Thank you.